Before we start modeling the ear, we'll move on to the third layer. Following the same steps we used when starting the head mesh using a circle, we'll start the ear mesh using a plane. In side view, use Ctrl left mouse button to extrude along the outer ear. Select and extrude these faces inward. Add an edge loop cut. Add another edge loop. Connect with a face here and add another cut. Continue filling the upper portion of the ear with faces, lining them up to follow the contours of the ear in our reference image. Moving on to the lower portion of the ear to continue building the topology. Display all edges. Add a subsurf modifier. This flat surface holds all the topology required. And to create depth, we simply translate outward in X. Gradually building depth. extruding out this edge loop a few times to create the ear canal. And closing it up with faces. Adjust the rotation. And continue adding depth by defining both volume and creases. Using the object mode undo and redo to track progress. Translating the center part inward with proportional edit to create even more depth. adding thickness and back part to the ear. Unhiding the first layer, we'll adjust the ear placement to match the head. Next, we'll join the ear to be part of the body mesh. With the ear selected in object mode, shift select the head and press Ctrl J. To adjust the ear shape without affecting the head, we'll enable Proportional Edits Connected Mode, or by pressing Alt-O on our keyboard. Holding the mouse over the ear, press L to select linked geometry. Working with both perspective and orthographic views to finalize the shape. Preparing both meshes before connecting them. And finally, connecting the ear to the head by adding new faces, merging vertices, rotating edges, and adding edge loop cuts.